Damps.
So as you guys can see, I did leave that thinning spot right there. I did not try to line up into it. I did not try to eliminate it just with my clippers by going up a lot higher. I just left it. I lined up what I could, and then I'm filling in the rest with some hair fibers. Now,
so what we're gonna do is we're gonna watch this video. So this guy goes out on a date. He decides to tell the girl he's going on a date with, first date, that he is wearing a hair unit, a hair piece. Let's watch it.
So are you nervous?
A little bit, yeah.
You'll be fine.
Yeah.
Breathe.
Breathe.
Keep breathing.
And you got...
Sorry. What did you...
No, I was going to say, you've got really good eyes.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much.
You've got good hair, to be
fair. I've got really good hair.
Yeah, have you always been, like, bright pink? Like a rainbow?
This guy had to comment on the hair. We know where this is going already. I guess anything to keep the chat going, you know?
Like this is all natural. This is, I don't have any extensions or anything now. You are blonde. You're like a strawberry blonde, aren't you?
Yeah, blonde, not ginger. On a date, there's always something I like to tell them first, rather than go a few dates down the line and then she finds out. I like to be open, be honest about it.
It's not even fair how much that does for a man. It's not even a little fair. Like, all it takes is one...
Damps.
You don't understand, like barbers like this are ruining women's lives, because you are making us go on second dates with people because they have this situation, and it just activates something in the back of our brains. It's like, he's got potential. He doesn't have a job. His numbers changed twice in the last 2 weeks, but he's got potential. Stop it. Stop giving them potential haircuts. All right, you're making us make mistakes and have potential babies.
Damps.
Stop it. Why is it so easy? Every man is just one haircut away from fine.
Damps.
Cause you say you in love, but you don't even know. Just be glad that I gave you some.
Damps.
That's the way you should be rocking a hair unit. What he just said, we're not trying to do this surprise the girl you're dating 4 days down the line, and then she breaks up with you because she feels like you're hiding something. No, you got to be confident. And this is a person who I could see wearing a hair unit for a very, very long time. Because that's how you got to rock it. It's with confidence. It doesn't suppress. It doesn't make you hide behind it. He's using it as a tool. You know what I mean? He's treating it like how you should treat money. You know what I mean? You get money, you move it. You invest it, and it makes you more money. He gets a hair system, and he gets more confidence. It's not the other way around. If you're hiding behind the hair system, if you're scared to tell people or talk about it, you just gotta live life to the fullest. Confidence. This guy, respect, trust.
So, you know, yeah, it's like something I've got to admit. I'll just tell you now, because like just so I get it over with now.
Go on, tell me.
To my hair.
Yeah.
Is a wig.
Jeez. That's like telling the girl you like her. That first time, you know, where it's like, you gotta get your emotions together. And be like, babe. You don't even say babe, you be like, oh, actually no, it's like your first kiss. So how do you guys think she's gonna react to this? Negative, positive, leave it in the comments below. How do you think she's gonna react to this? You think it's gonna be awkward? Or do you think she's gonna take it right in stride and run with it? Get in those comments.
Yeah. Like, my hair is a wig.
No, it's
yeah,
not.
Yeah, it is.
Because that thing looks good.
That is one of the best wigs I've ever seen.
Yeah,
in my
I know.
Life.
I used to be like clean shaven. And like, no. Yeah.
So your hair fell out?
So, like, 20 years old, it was like it was pretty much gone.
But so, his hairpiece looks really good. Like, let's give him a lot of credit. That looks amazing. I mean, that's one of the things. You just got to really focus on the hairline. There's always usually enough hair around the ends to create a nice blend. But it's the hairline. The density has to be right. You can't have a hairline that's super thick and in your face. You know what I mean? It has to be natural. Natural. Every single one of my clients so far has wanted some sort of natural aura to their hair. So whether it be at least some gaps in between the hairline, but not blacked out, not bulletproof. Because at that point, then you feel like something's up. You know what I mean? Like whether there's an enhancement like boost in there, or whether it's potentially not that person's actual hair. You know what I mean? This guy's hair, though, looks really good. The straight hair, we're usually working with a little more length. The one haircut I do feels a little more difficult, though, is dealing with straight hair very short. Straight hair very short is a little, you got to be a little more aware of what you're doing. You know what I mean?
I went to, like, this clinic. And I said, oh, I'm thinking about a hair transplant. He's like, yeah, sorry, Paul, you're too late for a hair transplant. It's too far gone. The only thing for you is a non-surgical hairpiece.
Yeah.
And I just went, a fucking wig. This is early on in the year. This wasn't a good look. I think there's a bit of an improvement there. If you don't see that, you're blind.
Oh, my God, that's amazing. Look. You do suit the bald head, though.
If you like the bald head, I can take it off. Girls say having no hair doesn't matter, but I'm telling you it does.
It's gonna change. Trust me. Mark my words. It's gonna change. And nothing people don't take into account with hair, okay? When you have your actual hair, and this is a lot of times why women wear hair that's not theirs, is because when it comes to hair, you have to style it. You gotta take care of it. You could damage this hair. You could do a lot to this hair. You could work with it every single day. And you don't have to worry about anything. You don't have to worry about growth or nothing because it's not your hair. You can just go get a new piece, right? And that's one of the big things is he can do whatever he wants. He can experiment. He can play with color. When I dyed my hair blue 2 years ago, last year, my hair was feeling like hay. I ended up having to shave that completely off. Completely off. Because my hair was feeling like hay. I fried it. But now see if that was a hairpiece. You could do whatever you want. You don't got to worry about nothing because you could just take it off and get a new one.
It's like you look in the mirror and go, but you put a fancy shirt on, but there's always something missing. I was actually at a bar and I'd had a chat with this girl. I said to like, get you a drink. She took my drink. I was like, yeah, end of the night. Can I get your number? And she said, no, I don't date bald people. And it was like, ow.
It's obviously a big thing that men deal with, isn't it?
Yeah, for sure. Like, I think people honestly think that lads don't suffer with looks. And I think girls expect this 6'5", tall, dark, handsome. Meanwhile, I'm like, right?
What are you like?
So.
It's not about looks. It's about a person that you connect with and whether you like them or not.
That's politically correct, but looks always play a role. Actually, let's break it down before you ever go to talk to somebody. You have to look at them and want to talk to them. If you look at them and you don't want to talk to them because you're judging them on their first appearance, we all do it. Please don't say you don't do it. We all do it. You look at somebody, they look like a dick, you're not going to talk to them. You're not going to talk to them. You know what I mean? If she looks like she's going to cuss you off, you're not going to talk to her. You're not going to talk to her. This is the winner. Watch this. You hit them with a smile. And then they smile back. And you both look good. Or you're both attracted to each other. That's before you ever say hi. You know what I mean? Before you ever say hi. And let's not forget. What's the frame? How important is a frame to a picture? It's everything. Your hair is your frame. Your hair is your frame. That's why everybody's getting cuts before they go out.
That's what life's about.
It is.
What do you say?
So does it come off at night?
It stays on until you take it off.
Yeah, so that's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. And I encourage anybody who comes to see me. Like, you got to tell your significant other. You got to tell the people you're going to spend a lot of time with, let them know. You know what I mean? Just because it'll take a burden off your chest. You're not walking around trying to hide anything, because that's stress. That's stress that nobody needs. And on top of that, it's you're going to be surprised when you realize people don't really care. They just really like what you look. They'll be astonished. They'll be like, you look good. But they won't care to what extent you went to make yourself look good. You know what overrides that in every situation? Confidence. If you look good and you have confidence, I mean, the world is your oyster. That's a fact. Take crumbs, make bread, subscribe, turn on that notification bell, like, comment. I want to see what you guys have to say about this video, or this whole situation, the scenario. Would you tell your wifey that you were wearing a hairpiece, or your significant other, your partner? Would you tell them that you were wearing a hairpiece? Damps, baby.
Damps. Damps.